experience.
Assalamualaikum and very good morning to one and all present here. Despite failure, you stand up. Despite the pain, you keep fighting. Keep dreaming to fly high and reach very big heights. The world needs more women like us. And our college, Center for Women's Studies, proudly welcome you all for the Women's Day celebration in the topic, Oh, Beautiful. Women develop leadership potential and become visible. Now I request Kanis to give away the prayer.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
The opening, Surah Al-Fatiha, Chapter 1 of the Holy Quran. In the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful. All praise is due to Allah, the Lord of the world, the beneficent, the merciful. Master of the day of requital, the alone to be worshipped and the alone seek for help. Guide us on the right path, the path of those upon whom Thou hast bestowed the favors, not of those upon whom the wrath is brought down, nor of those who have gone astray. Amen.
Thank you, Ganesh.
Our Center for Women's Studies has the distinction of being first UGC-sponsored center among the colleges in the Chennai city. The mission of Center for Women's Studies is educating women students about social inequalities that result from various social events that exist in the society. The Center for Women's Studies provides feminist center, gender and identity aware programs. It extends support and expands research on women's issues and promotes networking, advocacy and support for women and also serves as sources of information on gender-related activities and issues. The center is committed to the preservation, expansion and transmission of knowledge about women. Once again, I personally wish you all a very happy Women's Day. And now I request our director, Dr. S. Jamila Ma'am, to give away the welcome address.
Wish you all a happy Women's Day. First of all, I apologize for this late because the guest, she had some problem with traffic and on behalf of the management, principal, staff and students of Justice Bashir Ahmad Said College for Women, I deem it a privilege to welcome our guest for the day, Ms. Nisha Rajpati, for today's Women's Day celebration. She is a multi-talented, versatile personality. She has a long list of achievements to her credit. To mention a few, she is a national award winner for Best Teaching Excellence in Civil Service for Women. She is an assistant professor of economics at Hindustan University. She is a top UPSC faculty at Anna Academy. She is a national level motivational speaker. And she is Miss India International Kerala. Young Lifetime Achiever Award for 2020. and she has also received the Iconic Women of the Year 2020.
She has been awarded with International Young Women Economist Award at Sri Lanka. She is Most Young Dynamic Personality of the Year 2021. She has got the award. And beyond that, she is the director of an e-commerce company, Private Limited, Jolami. So this is brief. She has very good work experience working with top companies and presently at Hindustan University. She is also an economics analyst in Kerala. She is director for Jolami. She is director and co-founder for Ray Fashions with branches in Bangalore, Delhi, Kerala and Chennai. She has worked as guest faculty of economics in almost all the important IAS coaching centers, to mention a few like Kingmakers IAS Academy, Ganesh IAS Academy, Smart Leaders IAS Academy, Satya IAS Academy, Impact IAS Academy, etc. She has been visiting faculty and resource person in Nehru Yuva Kendra organization, Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports of Government of India. She is taking coaching classes for UPSC Civil Services exams from April 2016 till present. She is a knowledge coordinator and associate trainer for Nirbhaya Institute of Human Development. She is program coordinator for Nirbhaya Debating Society. She has many awards and recognitions to her credit. She has made many media appearances. She has appeared for live debate on national media MTV channel as a panelist. She has been a panel member on the topic, making local self-governments effective. She has appeared on discussions on various social, economical and political issues in Kairi People's TV and program Open Forum for Youth. She has done live webinars on economic topics and many other topics. She has many publications to her credit. She has published many research papers in international and national journals and has presented papers in national and international conferences. The list will go on if I go on reading. She is an editor and member of a number of organizations. Like, she is editor of Young Researcher in Chief, Para Research Foundation. She is also editor for Ray Fashion Magazine. She is a columnist for weekly publications and reputed magazines and selected newspapers like Hindu and She Magazine. Her organizing skills are exemplary, and she has many social welfare activities to her credit. She goes for all the important women-related social welfare programs, and the list goes on. I'm really happy to have you, madam, amidst us this morning. I welcome you.
Thank you, ma'am. Now I request Justice Advisor GM Akbar Ali sir to give the memento to our Chief Guest of the Day.
Still, you know, emergencies happen. But I'm so happy to see all of you, a lot of patients sitting over here. So give me a good afternoon to a lot of vibrant energy young girls. Come on, that's the spirit. And it's indeed a great pleasure. So before going to the topic of discussion, I should say that I was sitting there in a company, I don't know what to say. I felt as if I'm having a recall of what I've achieved. She was taking me through what all I've achieved and what all I've got. That was the motivation for me. I came to motivate you people, but I got motivated in that 5 minutes. Thank you for that, Dr. Jamila. Because you know me, when somebody tells that she's that, Jesus, it's okay. She was just making a beautiful script of what I've achieved, making me feel that I should achieve more. Come on. The place where I came to motivate the girls, I am getting highly motivated with double power pack. That is a kind of recharge for me. Thank you for recharging. Come on, give her a big love round. Thank you so much for advising sir as well for reoccupying them till the time I come. And he was just talking to me a few minutes regarding what he was telling the people. Those 4 to 5 sentences what he told me, one thing he said, we got to celebrate International Men's Day also once. Let's give a kudos to him for that, girls. Because see, today I'm here, not just women's. I'm going to tell you something even above that. People think it's women, S-M-A-H. It's not like that. It's something even greater. You got to break the barriers, break the glass ceilings, and make sure that there is gender equality, being a female, being a woman of strength and honor. That's what I'm going to tell you all throughout this session. And this will never be a lecture or a speech as such. Rather, what I'm going to tell you people is the story, or let's say some beautiful lines which I have framed out of my life. And today, if I'm able to stand right in front of you, there should be a reason for it. Right? So what I've underwent, what I've gone through in my life, those factors that we're representing over here. And once I was also a student like this. Even today also I'm a student, you know. I'm a student for her. I call her Miss A. You know that? You know what is any Malayalis here? Okay, very few. You know, in Kerala, Miss A is what you know. The school children, they call their teacher. They will never call them ma'am. They call Miss A. I call Dr. Jamila ma'am as Miss A. That means I'm a daughter. It's something like that, you know. I'm so happy that this women's center studies over here in association with the Justice Bashir Ahmed Sahib College Women is conducting an amazing program like this to make sure that the females out here is encouraged, motivated, and to put a light or a spark into your hearts. So thank you so much once again for this amazing program, for the coordination, for the organization, and you people, for the students, for coming and sitting all the way. Thank you, girls. You want me to stand here or you want me to walk and talk? Yeah, that's what I prefer. I think I'm audible, right? So yes, you have an amazing topic. Oh, you beautiful. How to develop your leadership qualities and to be visible. Why this topic of discussion today is because as far as 2021 UN Women's Day theme is concerned, the International Women's Day theme is concerned, it's about women leadership. And to make sure that there is equality even in this pandemic situation for both male as well as female. So people think that, you know, when you talk about leadership of women, it's just the women alone. It's not like that, you know. It's about growing together. So today, all throughout the session or the talks with you people, I'll tell you about the wonderful men in my life who helped me to stand here. Hadn't the men been not there, like my dad, my brothers, my colleagues, my friends, I would not have been able to grow to this extent. So there are good men out there also, even in your homes. It's just that you're not able to see it. Am I right, ma'am? So yes. So let me ask you a few things, girls, before starting, my young students. When you came for this session, when you came for this program, you will think that, okay, ma'am is going to come here and tell a few things about leadership. But I'm not going to really do that. I'm going to ask you questions. Anybody out in the crowd, please be free. Tell me 6 traits or quality a person should have to be a leader. Quick, especially a woman. I repeat, 6 qualities or traits, especially a woman should have to be a leader. Yes, please go ahead. Wonderful, yes.
Kindness.
Kindness.
Wonderful, correct. Yes, next.
Accountability.
What is it?
Accountability.
Wonderful, that comes with responsibility. Wonderful, next. Beautiful, beautiful, next.
Loyalty.
Yeah, yeah, loyalty, honesty, self-coach. Yes, next.
Patience.
Wonderful, yes, Sumi. Patience, yeah, next. Perfect. That's it. Six of my life show. What is your name? That's wonderful. Give her a big kudos, guys. That's wonderful, my friend. Yes. What all you said, courage, confidence, honesty, if you put in one single umbrella, it is not a discrimination. Once you are not discriminated, all these things will come to you. Come on, let me tell you something. All the females or the young girls and ladies out here, you are confident, you are courageous, you are honest, you are responsible, you are accountable, you have a very good decision-making capacity. But when there is discrimination, can you bring out those qualities out of yourself that is hindering you or stopping you? So once that is taken away, the root cause is taken away, automatically you will be able to flourish. Wonderful. But let me tell you what are the six qualities a leader should have, be it a man or a woman. Taking into consideration all the points you have put forward. One is vision. A leader should have a vision. That vision comprises of goal, your ambitions, and the faith you have in keeping on and on going. The second quality a leader should have is the mindset to explore no matter whatever happens. The third quality of a leader is accept failure. Be ready to fail. Come on. Because today you will succeed. Tomorrow, what if you cannot succeed? Only the ones who have tasted the, you know, the bitterness of failure, believe me, they can be successful. Because I have done that. Come on, he's even sneezed for that. Yes, sir, that's true, I believe. He's even sneezed. Really? Don't you think so? When you fail, you feel demotivated? Yes, at the back. You feel demotivated? You feel discouraged? You feel a lot of, oh my goodness, I failed, I did all these things. But when you never give up, and as one of the students said, patience. When you have patience, when you never give up, with the courage, confidence, what all points you said, now, when you're true to yourself, not to others, you will rise like anything. So I'll tell you something. It is okay to fail, to cry, to be broken into pieces. Get ready to fail, to be broken and to be hurt also. I repeat, it's okay to fail, hurt and be broken. But then comes a time where you rise, you heal and you overcome. I repeat, you rise, you heal and you overcome. Like a phoenix bird rising from the ashes. Don't you agree to that? So it's okay to fail, na? Why? Because you will learn a lot in life. Always if you keep succeeding, what is life? You know, I got a lot of failures here. You won't believe. I was a very studious girl in my school called a sub-coach, rank holder. But then at some point of time, you have packs of failures. I have failed in so many stages. I was a very good student, I'm a good speaker. I have failed in so many stages. Just because English nalla theriyum solite, we cannot say that I'm a good speaker. Illana mara nalla theriyum na pesa mudiyum appadi kedaiyadhu. The quality, the content, the modulation, that's very important. There was a point of time, back to back, or 6 to 7 competitions are the thodupu. I always think I'll win. When I go for debate competitions during my UG, you won't believe. I'll win. Every time I feel, I don't know, not even third prize. I used to wonder, I know very good English than those people, I talk well, but why? But then I had the patience of accepting my mistakes and understanding that I have to include a lot of knowledge into it, upgrade myself, and I got so many good mentors who taught me that. And then I started, you know, working on it. Like a baby girl, I started working on it. Then, the next 3 years of my graduation life was glorious for me. Hat-trick national debate winner. That's what I did in my life. Hadn't I left, okay, I'm failing, I'm not able to do anything. If I'm left like that, will I be able to stand and speak in front of you like this? So it is okay to fail, na? Because it makes you more stronger. See, stronger is not the strength in your physical body, it's in your mental ability as well. That's very, very important. So, for a leader, you should be ready to accept the failure. And as far as women is concerned, because all of you are beautiful creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't you think so? Yes, the God Almighty has created women with so many beautiful things.
See, keeping the men's here on the board, I think take a a little of opportunity to say that physically men's are very strong. Yes, I'll say my dad, my friends, of course, they're very strong. But when it comes to mental strength, they are strong, but not as stronger as us. Your mother can take care of you. She can cook. She can clean. She can do everything. Can a dad do that? But he can be a good source of strength. But he cannot do what she does, and she cannot do what he does. So everybody has a potential. You understand? So we have to understand and kind of make sure that come on, things are to be looked from that point of view. So for a leader, as I told you, vision, exploring, then third one is what? Okay to fail, because that only will give you success. What are the next points? As she said, communication is very true. The way you communicate, it's not that you have to give so many bombarders or talks and all. It's not like that. It's about ஒரு வார்த்தை பேசுமியா? அந்த வார்த்தையில அவ்வளோ அர்த்தம் இருக்கணும். You should have so much of meaning in it. That is a quality of a leader. And people say that, come on, I'm a leader, I'll walk forward, you follow me. What nonsense? Is that a leader? A true leader, he or she will make you walk beside you. They will never make you follow, because if you do that, you are a slave. You will never grow. So everybody of you has quality in yourself. And as far as women leadership is concerned, your leadership starts not in your college or your school or anywhere else or in your workplace. It starts right away at your home when you're born. The kind of habits you develop, the qualities you develop, don't you think so? எப்போ லீடர்ஷிப் குவாலிட்டி டெவலப் ஆகுது பசங்களா? வெரி இஸ் டெவலப்பிங் ஃப்ரம் வெரி யங் ஏஜ். யூ ஆல் இன் ஸ்மால் ஸ்மால் ஏஜஸ் யூ யூஸ் டு ஃபைட் னா யூ யூஸ் வெரி டாமினேட்டர் ரைட்? தட் இஸ் லீடர்ஷிப். எஸ் தட் இஸ் லீடர்ஷிப். யூ ஆர் பிகமிங் டாமினேட் பிகம் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் யூ கேன் டு தட். சோ யூ ஹேவ் டு ஸ்டார்ட் க்ரோயிங் தட் திங். ஆஸ் அண்ட் வென் த டைம் பாसेस வாட் ஹேப்பன்ஸ் இஸ் தட் many people they suppress the qualities they have because of so many difficulties they have. Emotional, mental, physical, financial. It will put them down. They can't explore. In some homes, if you see, you can't have no issues. You can study your schooling, your college, everything. But then get married. But the good qualities you have in inspiring the people, in inspiring society as an Indian female, is going somewhere. So what I will tell you is, right away from your home, from within yourself, Y-O-U. What is that? You. The three-letter word is very, very powerful. That is the real kind of leadership which makes you visible. It makes you beautiful, radiant, vibrant. What does it mean? If somebody comes to tell you, you cannot do this, you cannot do that. Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much for your valuable words. I'll say that. You won't believe people used to tell that to me, even today. Avala, like this. Avala. She is like that. Really, thank you so much for your appreciation. Because they don't determine my future. And I don't give an opportunity for them to determine me. And second thing is, when you attain degrees, titles, honors and all, you cannot put it out. You understand? You cannot put it out. You should make yourself visible. Opportunities will come. But how will you take care of the opportunities? How will you take care of the opportunities? You have to go behind it. சும்மா opportunities வராங்க. Come, opportunities coming, you become that, you become this. Really? Will it happen? So what you ought to do? What you got to do, guys? You have to chase. Chase like what? Chase like what? Like a sleepless leopard. I would say that. Come on, all the young girls out here are like that. I could see beautiful girls. Come on, all of you remove your mask for a while. Let me see you all. Quickly remove it. Let me see the smile in your face. Yes, at the back, my wonderful girls, what is happening? Yes, she's doing kind of to me. When I have called her, she's showing like this. What's your name? I really do that, sir, after some time. I'm like that. I'll go sit there and talk. I'm like that. See, girls, I'm telling you something, I'm like that, okay? I'll come sit and talk there. I'm very much courageous like that. Because I love females like anything, believe me. Because you want to inspire and you keep doing it. Nobody else can do that. That's the reason. So yes. Yes, the girl like this. What's your name? What is she doing? Huh? So active, I think she is. What are you doing in fact? So what I was telling you people. Yes, all of you remove your mask quickly. Come on, come on. COVID then I should get COVID first. I'm going to so many places. Smile. What is that? Smile. Are they Colgate advertisement by cinema? Smile. And ask to laugh. Smile. People are blushing. What is happening there? In the place you are sitting, what is sitting there? Smile. Smile. What is this? What is she doing?
You are such a creative man.
Come on, smile. Make a sound and smile. That is love. See, you see what all we girls can do? Come on, what all we women can do? We can make a smile to a laugh to a smile. So that is the capacity of women. Don't you think so? Yes, you can make a smile to a laugh to a smile. Just like this. And you can justify saying that this is what I am. This is how I am. Seriously, that is the world. Anyways, so I'm so happy to see you smiling. You know why? S-M-I-L-E. Then find a word called smile has a lot of impact in your life. Again, for a leader, especially for a woman, that's very important. Because that comes under the so-called quality of patience and perseverance. Because perseverance or perseverance, anyway you pronounce, that's very, very important for a girl. Even the Holy Quran it is said, or the Holy Bhagavad Gita, or the Holy Bible, whatever it is said that patience and perseverance, these two qualities will take you to greater heights. Don't you think so? Seriously, even the holy books, whichever you follow, people follow different books. But still, in everything, that's a common thing to say. And now, the biggest quality for a woman is to have these two. Because that will enable her to be a good leader. A good leader shouldn't be somebody who is so aggressive in all the issues. Rather, who is patient and also who can teach others the importance of consistency and perseverance. These two qualities, again, if you want to be a very good leader in life, you should have. And now, people are talking that we are not having equality, we are not having that, we are not having this. Do you think you are not equal? Do you have anybody felt you are not equal here? Yaar kaadha na equal illa, enna vada means that jaasthi irukku. Do you feel? Once again. So don't you think so? You should be proud enough to say that I don't need reservation. Don't you think so? When you go apply for an examination, when you go to somewhere or in the bus, women are having reservation. Good, we accept that. But you should be proud enough to say that we don't demand reservation. By the law of nature, reservation comes to us because that's how our body is made. But we never demand reservation to anybody. Somebody is offering us, well and good. The opposite gender is offering us. Yes, we are ready to accept it. But we never demand. But people say we demand. So if somebody comes and tells you that ladies first or gents first, just say something. Human beings first. The one with some bloody sense, they are first. It's nothing like man or female. We are here to make sure that the gender disparity, I repeat, the gender disparity is not happening. But if you see a country, India, I'm so sorry to say this. Come on, we have been a developing economy. Who would have done that? But India is not just Tamil Nadu or Kerala or Delhi or Maharashtra. We have so many other states like Bihar, Uttar, Orissa, Jharkhand, etc. Right? Have you seen the plight or the condition of women out there? Have you seen? Forget about those states in rural India. Because even today, 50%, approximately 49.8% of people are put up in rural India. The population of women is also quite higher there, not here. What is happening to them? Are they given opportunities? The government is doing so many initiatives, schemes, such like that. But are they given opportunities? Why? Because there is nobody to fight for them. Is it so? It's happening. There are people to fight for them. They have to develop themselves. So if you want to ignite a spark in your life or bring a light into yourself, you got to really, really understand. Come on. Nobody will come and do things for you. See, I can talk to you. I can guide you. Your teachers can teach you. But the real change, I repeat, the real change will happen only when you yourself want to bring it out in your life. That's why Mahatma Gandhi said, you must be the change you want to see in the world. Just repeat it. Which means, again, three letter word called you, Y-O-U, that has a leadership in it. Don't you think so? Don't you think so? So you should think, come on, you should think, you should do that. If you hear my life story, you'll be like, oh my goodness, seriously, have you undergone all these? Yes. And I'm so strong in saying that, yes, I've underwent. But those pieces, those broken pieces, didn't go in vain in the river. I collected, I made to a so strong pillar. At least till the moment I die, I'll be happy that I lived a life worthy of my soul and worthy of God's grace. That's it. You should be like that. Even if you live for a single day, you should never even give up on anything. People will say never give up. All these are quotes and dialects. You know what is never give up meaning? Never give up is never give up on your own self. Never even cry. If anybody cries now, the girls, I'll never call them, only children cry. You should be, when you are very sad, you should cry. But again, for a leader, putting out the emotions, that should be in your personal space, but not in public space. That becomes the biggest weakness for a woman, and also women aspiring to be a leader. Don't you agree? You shouldn't, because that's the biggest weakness. Achha, women are emotional. What emotional? Everybody has feelings. So, put it out in your private space, not in the public space. You should learn such kind of qualities. Tell me, how many of you here, of you people here, have organized a program? In your school level, or home, or even you are organizing some functions at home is also organizing, okay. Any sort of program or something, how many of you have organized? Very few. That's all? Okay. Do you do cooking? At least help your mothers. Amma, nam indiki inda guest varom, nam inda kalmu seyalam, nam andha sey kalmu seyalam. You serve your guest properly, na? What is that called as? Is that not organizing? Organizing na, or program organize pandrom mattum da organizing, ha? Is it so? Is it so? Come on, girls, quick. Huh? Is it so? Then what is organizing? Even the very little thing that you do in your day-to-day life, that is called as organizing. That has a hidden leadership within yourself, the potential for you to do greater things. Nobody is great the moment you are born. Small, sort of things, what you do, it adds up to a big ocean of stuff. And that's the place where you really explode. You know that? And you got to be like that. Even the very small thing you do in your life now, when you start appreciating that, when you start feeling good for it, that is the time when you really change. And not only yourself. Once you start appreciating yourself by looking into the mirror, by saying that, okay, I can do this today and I really do this, you'll be able to inspire others. You'll really be able to inspire others. How many of you help your friends? What symbol is this, by the way? From here and now, I'm getting them. What symbol is this? Are you not calling Jalilda? What symbol is this? I should show like this then. Look at it, girl. I'll catch you, wait. How many of you? What question I asked you? பரவாயில்ல ஏதோ சும்மா கை கொடுக்கல நினைச்சு சில பேர் தூங்கிட்டேன் தூக்கலாம் தூக்கிட்டு தூக்கிட்டேன் வெரி குட் எஸ் மாரல் சப்போர்ட் இமோஷனல் சப்போர்ட் ஹாவ் யூ எவர் ஹெல்ப் தெம் இன் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்டிங் வாட் இஸ் தேர் ஆல் செல்ஃப் Have you shown them the projection of what they are doing and what they can do to a greater extent? Feel grateful or feel free to criticize. You should always do that. I do that. I'm not that a good person, okay? I'm not that easygoing person. Seriously. But I'm really good to people who are really good to me. Because I criticize to their faith. This is not the way. But still, when you do that, I also give them solutions. This is what you can do in a better way. Because that will enable them to mold themselves into better personalities. So your friendship doesn't mean that you got to really, really, say good things to them just like that. You got to do it over for the perspectives. Yes, what is the discussion happening over there? The girl with the yellow and the green wala dupatta and the one over there. What is the discussion? May I know that? May I know that? You are all comfortable in English, right? You want Tamil? Solve the pa. No.
I am not first year.
Okay, all of you first year, sir. Chalo, that's so nice. So restless, sir. Because I am very restless. That's why I thought if you make me sit for half an hour there, something I'll do. Some delivery things I'll do and I'll get up. I can't. See, some people are like that. But doesn't mean that I'll never listen to what other person is saying. You know, that's there. Because we learn from others. Don't you think so? So, yes. Do you all want to hear about my story, how I came so far?
Yes.
But I will not say like a story. I'll say in a different way. How many of you want to hear? See, there is nothing much of a story as such. I belong to a very little town called as Kollam. It's called as the cashew capital of the world. I hail from God's own country, the state of Kerala, from the cashew capital of the world, that is the district of Kollam. And today, I am surviving myself the past 10 years in Nammoru, Chennai, which is the place which enables me to grow. So, Chennai, I don't know Tamil, because I've talked to students, but I just managed. There are a lot of people who said I don't know Tamil. But today, I'm happy that I'm able to talk. People are able to understand. I'm able to communicate what I want in the language, whatever the language it is. So, just imagine being in an opulent Muslim family. It was not an easy journey for me. It was never an easy journey for me. You know, I have seen things which are very disastrous. Not every girl in a home will see. You have your difficulties, you have your stuff. I had a very good financial background, I had so many good things. But I want to fly out. I want to explore. There were so many difficulties, obstacles which did not let me fly out. It was like the pressures from the family background, not my mom and dad, they're really good, but the relatives or whatever. Why should she be allowed to go outside? She can study here, she can do things, she can do whatever she wants. I never wanted to have a life. That was not my ambition. I understood that because of my teachers. I wanted to be a part of society. I started following a lot of things like that. But I embraced my religion so close to my heart. See, everybody has their faith. And today, because of that only, I'm alive. I can say that. So, I was so strong. I kept on praying. Please give me a way to move out of this place and enable me to explore. By the permissions of my family members. This is the prayer I had. I never wanted to ignore them also. Because at the end of the day, your family is a beautiful thing you have. Wherever you go, blood is blood. Right? You can't replace blood. The blood relations you have. No matter you say you don't want also, you cannot replace. That's a law of nature. You'll get to know. Because you're all small, young girls. Once you grow up, you'll get to know the meaning of that. So I just really wanted to. My mother was very supportive for education. I had a very good European style of schooling. That is a problem, you know. That is a problem where, my father's family was not supportive. But why should she study there? Because my mother wanted me to talk English. She was just, she just wanted that. But when you study in such kind of places, the people whom we communicate, the people whom we mingle, it will change our mindset. Yeah. Naturally, it happens. So, it happened for me also to move out slowly, slowly. So, I started finding ways for it. But things were not that easy. Then, a day came where I broke the glass ceiling. I said, yes, it's time for me to explore. I came out, I started doing a lot of competitions. I started in tuitions, you know, because I wanted to be independent. I understood that if I'm dependent, every now and then, I have to sacrifice on one thing. So, because of little of knowledge what I had, I started in tuitions for people. And with that little income, I never depended on my parents because I never asked them. I said I want to go and I got scholarships, I studied. When I came to my UG, things were again fine. But there started the life of a single female, I can say. It was all alone in hostel because staying away from home, things were totally different. A lot of connections, a lot of contacts, people will come to pull you down, people will come to pull you up. So I had a lot of things like that. But then my life was smooth. Then I came to Chennai after my graduation. Where it was totally a new world for me. People were different, things were different. Oh my goodness, I didn't know how will I survive. There was a point of time when I had to stop my education for my family. My mother fell sick in the year 2014. She had a brain stroke, which was not that acceptable. I do not know what to do. So I have to go back. Stopping my studies, you have to be with her. But then even then she told me, always she used to say, no matter for anything or for anybody, don't give up on what you want. But my HODs that time was so good that they let me have the permission to write the exams and so many things like that. Again, I came back. All these things are naturally, will naturally happen in anyone's life. But you know, the biggest battle, what I had in my life was, I was in the peak of my career, I can say. I went to Japan for the President Women of India for a program and all, and I came back. Suddenly, I was infected with PTSD, which is called as post-traumatic stress disorder. It's the highest form of depression. You all know what is depression, right? We'll be like this. So just depression means you'll be sad about. What about active depression? It's not an easy thing. So I was infected with that when I did not know that I had this. But my body, my mind, the way I talk, everything changed. People were scared whether I'll be alive. I reduced 14 kgs, 1/4. Drastically, the old woman I became. Seriously. I was so devastated. There were some issues which I couldn't accept. Because there was one incident that happened, that trauma did not get me back. I was like, oh my goodness, is this happening to me? How did I fail not to know this is happening to me? So, no medicines, nothing could help me. But the faith I had in God, my religion, whichever religion you follow, the faith I had and the hope I had pulled out being ends that brought me back to life. So many new people I met. You know what people said? Do that, do this, you'll be fine. But what did I do, you know? As the course of time passed, I started fighting with my own self. I was fighting a battle with my own self. I was so scared. I was so feared. Like, whether I can talk like before, can I come and face the people like before? Will I be able to address an audience? Will I be able to get a class? I lost everything. Because I used to talk continuously, okay? During that time, for a 15-minute lecture, which I'm taking a paper and reading, it took me 2 hours. Recording, re-recording. I was like, oh my goodness, what is happening to me? What is happening to my brain, my body? Then, I really requested few people who came to my life. I don't know where those people are today. Seriously, I'm telling you. They came as a miracle to me. Those people, or let's say those two people, I don't know from where they came and from where they went. It was just like have you seen movies and all that, rising you, pulling you up. Some sort of power, I don't know what was that, that was instilled in myself, where I started understanding that you have to fight the battle within yourself. I started eliminating the four-letter word called as fear, F-E-A-R. I deleted that out of my life. Because fear had two meanings. Face everything and rise. Or, what is it? Face everything and run away. I opted for the first option to rise. And it was not again easy for me. I had a lot of difficulties, but then, given the PTSD, I couldn't even address a public platform. Because when I go out, I was looking at my old pictures, how beautiful I was before. What happened to me? I'm devastated. I couldn't do anything at all. The leadership qualities I had, the command, or the authoritative skills, speaking skills I had, everything got disappeared. Even my parents couldn't figure out what is happening to this particular girl. Is she gone mad? Or somebody done something to her? They tried everything. They even wished, at one point of time, some of my very close people, it's better she was not alive. Because somebody who's so good or who's doing great, who want to do great in life, suddenly devastating is not a joke. How would you feel? You feel so powerful, right? I hated people looking at me with sympathy. Really, I don't like people looking at me with sympathy or empathy. You feel so discouraged. I stopped going to public platforms because I couldn't. I took around the break of 6 months. Nobody knew where I was. No social media contact, nothing. Sab kuch nothing. I spent more than so. I don't know how many hours I would have spent alone. When I used to wake up in the morning, I used to feel a pit in my stomach. I want every single day to be night. I never wanted daylight. I wanted darkness. But then I understood one thing, guys. Never expect anything from anybody. Expectation is the biggest mistake people have. You can expect the person to be good. Never expect. Seriously, I told you that. I just tell people one thing in my life. This is what I learned. Be like a tree. You know tree, right? Tree has so much of roots. The roots will be as 10 years, 20 years, 50 years, 100 years. When they keep growing, they have roots. Now, today the tree may have a branch. Tomorrow, another branch. Sometimes you have to cut one branch. That is okay. You will have another branch coming up. What about the roots? Will the roots be destroyed? No. It will go more deep down. So even you in your life, be like a tree and have branches and never expect any of the fruits from that branch. Seriously, don't expect. Because that's something which I learned in my life. And because of that today, I'm so happy. Really, I'm very happy. I'm happy to address the platforms. I'm happy to address the females, the men, everyone out there. You won't believe, I have more male students as children, students than females. Females across I have, but more men. Do you know why they come to me? They come and tell, you are an amazing female teacher. We are proud to listen to whatever you say. Because I tell them one thing, if you are my student, if you follow me, give respect to your next companion or your co-gender. Unless until you don't do that from your heart, you will never rise. And that's one reason even today they come. And so many females out there, I used to tell them, no matter whatever, you have so many difficulties. Enala mudiyala, avanga appadi solranga, appadi solranga, okay. You can find a solution within yourself. See, I found a solution within myself. And the battle was so, so huge. That moment I decided, come on, I am going to really, really take this experience of mine to various platforms and inspire the ladies out there. You won't believe the girls, when somebody is infected with a disease like cancer, with AIDS, with tumor, whatever, you feel very disappointed because you are in medication. What medicine you have for depression, that's your active depression? Some pills some doctors will give for sleeping. That's it. What else you have? There is no medicine. The only medicine is? What is only medicine? Faith, hope, and understanding that you are not less than anything. And nobody can put you down for any reason. Seriously, it's because it is with the you know your hearts and brains. No medicine can help you. Only the medicine of motivation, the medicine of self-development, the medicine of self-realization of your real motive, goals, and perspectives can help you. Because that helped me a lot. See, in your life today, you will be like this. Tomorrow, you do not know what happens. I never knew this will happen to me tomorrow. I'll really tell you, I was standing and talking on a platform like this. 2 to 3 days back, after 2 to 3 days, this happened to me. I didn't know. It was starting for me. People who saw me a couple of days or week back in a platform, they couldn't believe this has happened to me. That is life. But the way you fight for it is very, very important. Never give excuses in your life to anybody. Don't say, just be honest in saying what you want. See, this is what has happened. I'm happy to say that this has happened. Why would I give excuses to another person, no matter whoever it is? Why would you do that? No need. Never degrade or lower yourself or anything as such. And as a young, emerging, vibrant girls, I'll tell you something. You should start empowering others. You know how will you empower? You have all heard about women empowerment. What is women empowerment? Girls, women empowerment. Is that women empowerment? Talking to women is women empowerment? No. I don't promote women empowerment. Rather, I promote development of women by the women. That's more important. It should be women-led development. That is what even in the 2019 budget of Government of India they said. Empowering is what you know. You are educated. But due to some reasons, you can't achieve what you want. So motivating you, come on, do this. That is empowering. But the real development happens when somebody is completely devastated or deprived of the basic facility at the minimum. Okay? They have been brought back to life. And then enabling them to take a lead forward as a leader. When you create leaders among others, see you. When you are a leader, you can create another leader. That is called as women-led development. That is what you should do. That is what even the UN women, organizations, even they say that. It's not just about empowerment or any feminist talks and all. And by the way, what is feminism? What is feminism? See, you're all young girls. You should know what is feminism. Huh? Freshman school, these people, notorious, because I was notorious, don't worry. I was even more notorious. Tell me what is, yaarukku theriyadha feminism enna? Have you heard, kettirukkeengala andha vaarthai? Edho pengalukkaga pannano, adhu thana feminism, appadiya? Appuram solunga, let me hear the thing, what is feminism?
Supporting women's equality,
Yeah, supporting women, okay. Okay, then.
Gender equality.
Wonderful, gender equality. Aprom. Yeah, she's a feminist, yeah. She's a feminist. Naray per solong patingla. What is that? And the work you are after, you know, you can't talk about it. Feminism is not to support people. It's not like that. You know what is feminism? Those who do not know, I'll tell you. What is the definition? Feminism is nothing but it deals with the gender female, we the females, to develop, to fight for our rights, and also to ensure that we are not discriminated at any cost. We are getting what we're supposed to get. That is called as feminism as per the dictionary word. பெண்களை வந்து சப்போர்ட் பண்றது அவங்களுக்கு அதை அதை பேசுறது அதெல்லாம் தான் ஃபெமினிசம் பட் இஃப் யூ ஆஸ்க் வாட் இஸ் ஃபெமினிசம் பீங் அ ஃபெமினிஸ்ட் எகனாமிஸ்ட் யூ நோ வாட் ஐ வில் சே ஃபெமினிசம் இஸ் நதிங் பட் இன்வால்விங் போத் தி ஜெண்டர்ஸ் கிவிங் அ லிட்டில் ஹையர் வெயிட்டேஜ் டு தி ஃபீமேல் ஜெண்டர் பிகாஸ் நாட் எவ்ரி ஃபீமேல் இஸ் ஏபிள் டு டெவலப் செகண்ட் திங் இஸ் ரெஸ்பெக்டிங் தி ஆப்போசிட் ஜெண்டர் யூ ஷுட் நாட் ஹேவ் ஜெண்டர் டிஸ்பாரிட்டி டிஸ்பாரிட்டினா அந்த அந்த கேப் பிட்வீன் மேல் அண்ட் ஃபீமேல் When you are able to respect both the genders and make the other gender, male gender, to support you and ensuring that you are growing, that is called as feminism. It is the idea of, you know, including both the factors for a peaceful and harmonious life in the entire globe. That is called as feminism. It's not just promoting women. It's about so many other perspectives. That is feminism. Okay. In the other article, feminism, paathum bodhu. உண்மையான ஃபெமினிசம் இதுதான் நிறைய பேருக்கு அது தெரியல பீப்புள் ஆர் லைக் யூனோ பெண்களை சப்போர்ட் பண்றது மட்டும்தான் ஃபெமினிசம் அப்படி கிடையாது வென் யூ க்ரோ யூ ஷுட் மேக் யுவர் அதர் பீப்புள் ஆல்சோ க்ரோ தட் கன்சிஸ்ட் ஆஃப் யுவர் மேல்ஸ் யுவர் வாட் ஆர் த கோ ஃபேக்டர்ஸ் வாட் எவர் இட் இஸ் தட் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் ஃபெமினிசம் அண்ட் பீங் அ வுமன் ஆர் பீங் அ கேர்ள் அகெய்ன் டு பி அ லீடர் வாட் யூ ஷுட் டூ யூ ஷுட் ஹேவ் குவாலிட்டிஸ் ஆஃப் சப்போர்டிங் ஆர் ரெஸ்பெக்டிங் தி ஆப்போசிட் ஜெண்டர் நினைக்கணும் The quality of embracing and accepting things the way it is. And it's not that easy to be a woman, you know. Because a woman is a full circle. Within her is the power to nurture, care and transform. A woman can give everything. You know why? A woman can give everything, people say. Why? She can give care. She can show what love, care and nurturing is to a man. That is why it is said that woman is everything. Have you noticed something? Some people doesn't respect females, some so-called patriarchal people. But they're forgetting one thing. A woman is the one who gives birth to a man. And now this man is also raised by a woman. This man will fall in love with the woman and again get married to another woman. But they don't understand the importance of women. So you should make them understand. We are like a circle. That's why I said a woman is a full circle. Within her is the power to nurture, create and transform. And I want all of you out in this hall, guys, all the beautiful girls out here, to believe in three things in life. Be a girl of an attitude, a woman of a class, and a lady of strength and honor. I repeat, a lady of strength and honor. Do you want to repeat it? Be a girl of an attitude, and a woman of a class, and a lady of strength and honor. You know what is strength and honor? Never giving up on anything and putting your face down. Keep your head held high, no matter whatever it is. Because the five letter word called W-O-M-E-N, women, it has so much of meaning in it. It has so much of meaning in it. So always develop these qualities within yourself and make a point that no matter whatever, you keep going. அது கொண்டு நீங்க எக்ஸாம்ல வந்து ஃபர்ஸ்ட் மார்க் வாங்கணும்னு அவசியம் கிடையாது. It's about the way you grow, you develop your personalities. You can be a good academician, you can be a good entrepreneur, you can be a good mother, you can be a good wife, you can be a good friend, you can be whatever you want. Every role has its own responsibility. You should actually implement it. So the life of women is not that easy. But we will make it easy. It is true, it is not easy. But instead of saying not easy, eliminate or cut N-O-T-N-O-T and say yes, it is easy. Because we build a beautiful life.
Nobody else can create a life like us, you know? Nobody else can create. Don't you think so? Yes, at the back. Nalla pesitranga. Don't you think so? இங்கிருந்து நீங்கெல்லாம் டிகிரி வாங்கி போகும்போது ஓ எனக்கு டிகிரி படிச்சேன் அந்த கிராஜுவேஷன் மெஸ் ஆயிட்டே வில் டூ மை யூ நோ போஸ்ட் கிராஜுவேஷன் லேப் திஸ் எக்ஸ்ட்ரா ஸோ பீப்புள் ஆர் லைக் பட் ஐ டெல் யூ சம்திங் இந்த மூணு வருஷ காலத்தில் இட்ஸ் நாட் அபவுட் த டிகிரி அண்ட் நாலேஜ் யூ கெயின் தட் இஸ் ஒன் சைட் யூ ஷுடன்ட் பி டூ மச் எக்ஸைட்டட் பை த டிகிரி ஹானர்ஸ் டைட்டில்ஸ் வாட் யூ ஹேவ் ராதர் யூ ஷுட் பி மோர் ஹாப்பி அபவுட் யுவர் டிட்டர்மினேஷன் டிசிப்ளின் டெடிக்கேஷன் கம்பேஷனட் ஆட்டிடியூட் இன்டெகிரிட்டி ஆட்டிடியூட் யூ ஹேவ் இந்த மாதிரி குவாலிட்டிஸ் ரொம்ப இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் ஒரு மனுஷனுக்கு ஹவு ஹம்பிள் அண்ட் சிம்பிள் யூ ஆர் The qualities you learn through your college days that will enable you to be a good feeling and a good human being at the end of the day. So quickly, all of you tell me, we the women will always strive to be a better woman. Say that.
We the women will always strive to be a better woman.
And empower.
And empower.
Our fellow women.
Our fellow women.
Because.
Because.
We are raised by stronger women.
We are raised by stronger women.
That is our mothers. That's a reality. Thank you so much for having me here, my young girl. I'm very, very happy to see all of you. Jay. Thank you, ma'am, for all this. Thank you so, so, so much, ma'am. Really, I can't come out from the words. And thank you for speaking of the reality.
That's the reality.
Yes,
I agree.
Yeah,
are you audible?
Yes.
I have a voice. You know, Suma Vandita, from the Google and the YouTube and if you talk something, anybody can do that. You can buy, you can find the books, you can Google up and see those quotes. But when somebody talks from their real life, that makes a mark. Complete a spark, illana kuda, inge or spark irukku, yeah. That is more important. In the whole throughout is, I think 1 hour I took, right? I think I took 1 hour. In this 1 hour speech, if you didn't understand everything also, at least few things you would have understood, right? And the few things la, oru chinnada oru vishayamaga you keep in your brain, or your heart, and follow that. That will take you to greater heights. Believe me, my young girls, it will take you to greater heights. I'm so happy to see all of you.
It's really a draw over now. Thank you so, so much, and my heartfelt gratitude to you, my personal gratitude to you for, no, you have added to me one of the inspiring women list in my own personal list. Thank you so much. And now I request our director, ma'am, to announce the results of the competitions, which is the logo making competition.
That's another 10 minutes, we'll wind up. I know you are listening. The Center for Women's Studies, we thought we have to design a logo because we have completed nearly 15 years of our journey empowering women. So we just plan to have a logo for ourselves. And I know that all young girls are very creative in your mindset. And I thought I should make this as an interdepartmental competition. And so it was announced. And to my surprise, many girls had submitted their logo, their creativity, and they have done very beautiful logos. Nearly 97 entries we had got. 97 girls participated in the logo competition. And because this is a logo competition, we could give prize for only the best one because it cannot be a logo can be only a single one. So first, second and third is not allowed. So we thought of giving you a first prize, that is the best prize, best logo. And not only that, I wanted just to show you all the logos which were framed by our girls, both the day college as well as the afternoon session. I wanted to bring out the creativity of girls. And I wanted to just show you. So quickly we'll have a glance of those videos. Oh. So yes, girls, did you all notice something? We didn't say Women's Day to each other. Happy Women's Day to all of you. Did you say to each other?
Yes.
Come on, shake your hands and say quickly.
Happy Women's Day.
Oh my goodness. Look at the happiness. That is COVID-19 protocol now. No social distancing. Okay, enough. That's a happy Women's Day to all of you in my heart. Okay? Now we'll just go through the logos that were designed by our girls, both from day college as well as the afternoon session. There were 97 participants. Yeah. Yes, definitely. Because I didn't want all this creativity to go into me. Actually. Yeah, because we are having this COVID thing, they sent us through online only. Yes, definitely. All of them are winners. All of them are winners. So now we have, before going to the next thing, I'd like to say, we have chosen one best logo, and the reason for choosing that logo is also there, because it has a content. The logo conveys a content. It conveys that women are like butterfly. They have to be soft, but they should not be, people should not be able to catch them. They have to fly, keep on flying. And they have to attain their self. They have to reach their goal and become a star. And all the girls in this college, I wish that you are like butterflies. You be very soft, feminine, very soft and beautiful, multicolor and all that. But still, people should not touch you. People should not look down upon you. They have to look upon you. Okay? So that is why we have chosen that logo for Center for Women's Studies. And so the winner of the logo contest, the best award, best logo award, goes to Taslima Nazreen of third year BCom from the afternoon session. There are some corrections to be made. She has to come and meet me to do the spelling mistakes there. But this logo has been chosen for the Center for Women's Studies from this year 2021 onwards. Congratulations to Taslima Nazreen. Is she here? We'll we would like to give her this sheet. Is there anyone from her department? Third BCom afternoon session. Third BCom afternoon session. I request our chief guest to hand over this prize to the girl. She is absent today, so on her behalf, the Center for Women's Studies Secretary, Wajida, will receive it. And last but not the least, we have the Center for Women's Studies has two secretaries from the day session and two secretaries from the afternoon session. So on this occasion of Women's Day celebration, I would like to felicitate the two secretaries of the day college session with the service cup. I request our advisor, Sir Justice G.M. Akbar Ali, who was always supportive and continuous motivation, which makes me stand on this position. He always gives me a lot of encouragement, and I learned taking things very coolly from him. Actually, this is really a very good lesson I have learned from Sir. I request Sir to hand over the service cups to my secretaries. Ms. Wajida Kausar from Department of Political Science. Lakshmi from Department of English. Congratulations to both of you. Thank you, sir. Thank you, madam. I should really apologize to Akbarani, sir, because he told he'll come late, but we were late in starting the program. It was unexpectedly. So I apologize again, sir.
My dear girls, if you have any questions, please feel free to ask. If you have any questions to our ma'am, to our chief guest. Yeah, come without questions, sir. Come.
They will have many questions, ma'am, but because it is 1 o'clock, the clock struck 1. The mouse will run down. So let us go for the vote of thanks, Wajida.
I take this opportunity to showcase my sincerely gratitude, and I thank our principal ma'am who had been our pillar of support, and also my heartfelt gratitude to our director ma'am Dr. S. Jamila for giving us complete freedom for being ourselves and allowing us to do what we think, and for being a very huge support system. And I would like to thank my co-secretary Ms. Kritika Annalakshmi. Thank you for being a huge support. And also, I would like to thank our Pasha Bhai and Sardar Bhai for giving us a complete technical support, and thank you all. And I thank all the staffs and all my HODs and all my teachers, and I would like to thank you all for being patient and having a very hope you had a great session. Thank you.
Before we raise for the national anthem, girls, all of you sweet girls, I am very, very thankful for you, for having patience and listening to the motivational speech. So all those who have registered, who have given your names on the registration list, please go to room number 207, that is in front of the clinic, in the Diamond Jubilee block. You can take a refreshment from there and go home. Okay? Happy Women's Day. Let's all raise for the national anthem. Wajida, start singing. You can join, others can join.
Stop.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, girls.
Thanks, trainer. And